As I've indicated in previous lectures, the lipids are an incredibly diverse set of molecules, but as we will see, they have very common roots in a very simple molecule. In this lecture, I'll start that process by talking about fat and fatty acid metabolism. Now, fat metabolism is something that all of us want to do if we can, if we're worried too much about how much we're carrying around. So first, I want to talk about fat breakdown. Fats and oils are, as we've seen, triglycerides, and fat is stored in our body in specialized cells called adipocytes. The fat is important to travel in our bloodstream, but it's also a difficult way to travel because it's not water-soluble, whereas our blood actually is mostly aqueous solution. So to travel in the bloodstream, fat must go through complexes called lipoprotein complexes, and you probably know them as LDLs and chylomicrons. Fats are broken down into fatty acids and glycerol, its constituents, constituent components, by the action of enzymes called lipases. You can see on the screen a typical fat molecule. It has a glycerol backbone, as shown here, and you can see ester bonds between all the fatty acids and the glycerol. Now, each of those individual fatty acids are targets of action of different lipases. The first one shown at the top is a target of an enzyme known as hormone-sensitive lipase, and it will cleave only the first fatty acid. The second fatty acid was cleaved by an enzyme called diacylglycerol lipase, and the third enzyme is cleaved off by an enzyme called monoacylglycerol lipase. The product of that is a glycerol molecule and three fatty acids. If we're moving to make a fat, then it's not the simple reversal of the process, although it's similar. The starting point for the synthesis of a fat is not glycerol, but glycerol 3-phosphate, as you can see on the screen. In the first step of the reaction, glycerol 3-phosphate is converted into a molecule called lysophosphatidic acid. And that simply is a glycerol 3-phosphate that had a fatty acid attached to position 1 by an enzyme called acyltransferase 1. A similar reaction adds the second fatty acid, as you can see here, by an enzyme called acyltransferase 2. At this point, we have a molecule called phosphatidic acid, and as we will see, phosphatidic acid is a branch point in the synthesis of other lipids. Now, the fatty acids in phosphatidic acid are usually saturated at position 1, meaning all single bonds, and usually unsaturated at position 2, meaning having one or more double bonds. Phosphatidic acid can be converted into fat in only two more steps. First, the phosphate part of phosphatidic acid is removed by a phosphatase, as you can see here. That leaves behind a molecule called diacylglycerol. Diacylglycerol is converted into a triacylglycerol, which is either a fat or an oil, by the enzyme acyltransferase 3. Now, whether something is a fat or an oil depends upon whether or not it is a solid at room temperature, a fat, or a liquid at room temperature, called an oil. Chemically, the differences between these two are not very significant. They arise from the composition of the fatty acids within the fat. A fat is a molecule that contains mostly saturated bonds, and therefore is what gives it the property of being a solid at room temperature. An oil, on the other hand, has a considerable amount of unsaturated bonds within it and results in being a liquid at room temperature.